श्रीकाशिवसंवारं अहं शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिनि व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः ॐ यो ब्रह्माणि विदाति पूर्वं वेदागश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुम्हदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मोक्षुरो हि शरणमहं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः आम्नायन्ते संसिद्धमादिमध्यान्तवर्जितमानन्दघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे24th introduction. In the 23rd sutra, the reason why Brahma is not cognized by the sense organs is because it is beyond the sense organs. That was mentioned as tad avyaktam ahi, tad Brahma avyaktam na chakshusha grihyate napi vacha ityadi shrutir ahi yasmat karanat ityartha. So this Brahma being avyakta is not indriya gochara. To that the purvapakshi objects says tarihi evam tarihi. In that case, if Brahmatma is not accessible to the sense organs to चक्षु आदि इंद्रियास और वागादि इंद्रियास टू ज्ञान इंद्रियास और कर्म इंद्रियास इफ इट इज नॉट एक्सेसिबल एंड फर्दर व्हाट इट हैज बीन सेड एल्सवेयर व्हाट मनसा सह सो मनसा सह आल्सो द वाक रिटर्न्स दैट हैज आल्सो बीन मेंशन्ड सो Antakkarana also cannot objectify, not only sense organs, but Antakkarana also cannot objectify the Brahma Tattva, Brahmatma Tattva. Thereby, Tarhi Sarvada Brahma Grahana Bhave Moksho Nasya Adityatah. If Brahma is not accessible to the Jiva, then where is the possibility of Moksha? Because what is the sadhana mentioned in the Shruti? आत्मा बारे द्रष्टव्यः सो द आत्मा शुड बी सीन द्रष्टव्यः मीन्स शुड बी वन शुड हैव अ विजन ऑफ दिस आत्मा एंड नाउ यू आर सेइंग दैट आत्मा कैनॉट बी हैड अ विजन ऑफ इफ आत्मा कैनॉट बी सीन कैनॉट बी ऑब्जेक्टिफाइड देन श्रुति सेइंग दैट श्रवण मनन निध्यासन इज द मीन्स टू आत्मदर्शन would not be appropriate. This is the Pura Paksha. Moksha will become impossibility because Moksha Sadhana is Atma Darshana and Atma Darshana is not going to be possible if Atma is not Indriya or Managrahya, Manograhya. Ityataha, to that Bhagavan Sutrakara Siddhanti answers Apicha Samurodhane Pratyakshanumanabhyam अपि च संराधने प्रत्यक्षानुमानाभ्याम अपि च संराधने प्रत्यक्षानुमानाभ्याम संराधने नॉट संरोधने संराधने सो संराधने मीन्स व्हेन द एक्चुअली एल्सवेयर इट इज सेड भक्ति ज्ञान प्रणिधानम संराधनम भक्ति ज्ञान प्रणिधान ईश्वर प्रणिधान इत्यादि आर कॉल्ड एज संराधन बट रियली व्हाट When the antakkarana is resolved, in Shushupti Avastha, what is known is Shuddha Atma. How is it known? By being that. Without knowing any other thing as oneself, one knows oneself as oneself. But avidya is there. In Shushupti Avastha, therefore Samadhi, Samradhana meaning is Samadhi, in Samadhi, Samradhane, अपि च प्रत्यक्ष अनुमानाभ्याम बिकॉज प्रत्यक्ष इज श्रुति एंड अनुमान इज स्मृति सो विथ प्रत्यक्ष श्रुति एंड अनुमान स्मृति प्रमाण वी नो दैट इन समाधि आत्मा रिमेन्स विदाउट एनी एसोसिएशन विद द अंतकरण सूक्ष्म शरीर और स्थूल शरीर देर बाय दिस आत्मा शुद्ध आत्मा फ्री फ्रॉम दी उपाधीज ऑफ द शरीरत्रय विदाउट एनी अविद्या संबंध ऑल्सो एट दैट मोमेंट द वे इट इज देर इन सुषुप्ति इन समाधि इवन दैट इज नॉट देर बिकॉज आत्मा शाइन्स फोर्थ नॉट ओनली एज आनंद स्वरूप बट एज सच्चित स्वरूप ऑल्सो चैतन्य स्वरूप देर बाय सत्स्वरूप इज रिकॉल्ड इन वेकिंग अप फ्रॉम सुषुप्ति आई वॉज देर एंड आनंद स्वरूप इज ऑल्सो रिकॉल्ड बट चैतन्य स्वरूप इज नॉट रिकॉल्ड इट इज रिकॉल्ड इफ वन अंडरस्टैंड दैट आई डिड नॉट नो एनीथिंग सो अज्ञान कैन बी नोन ओनली बाय वन सेल्फ इफ आई हैव नॉट अंडरस्टूड समथिंग आई माई सेल्फ नो दैट आई हैव नॉट अंडरस्टूड सो आई कीप ऑन आस्किंग क्वेश्चंस कीप ऑन रिसर्चिंग टिल आई अंडरस्टैंड सो माई अज्ञान इज ऑल्सो नोन टू मी इन सुषुप्ति ऑल्सो अज्ञान इज नोन इन द मैनर दैट आई डिड नॉट नो एनीथिंग दैट इज अज्ञान विच इज नोन माई स्वरूप इज नॉट नोन एज चैतन्य स्वरूप बट इफ वन इंक्वायर एज टू हाउ कुड आई हैव नोन दैट आई डिड नॉट सी एनीथिंग दैट आई सॉ डार्कनेस विदाउट माई बीइंग चैतन्य स्वरूप सो सच्चित एंड आनंद स्वरूप ऑल थ्री आर नोन इन सुषुप्ति हाउ एवर ऑन वेकिंग अप इन समाधि ड्यूरिंग समाधि इट्सेल्फ आनंद इज नोन स्वरूप आनंद इज नोन देयरफोर अपि च संराधने प्रत्यक्ष अनुमानाभ्याम इज द सूत्र सूत्रार्थ विल लुक एट वृत्ति अपि च एनम परमात्मानं संराधने समाध्यवस्थायां कृतार्थाः पश्यन्ति इति प्रत्यक्ष अनुमानाभ्याम श्रुतिस्मृतिभ्याम कश्चित् धीरः प्रत्यगात्मानमैक्षत आवृत्तचक्षुः अमृतत्वमिच्छन् इत्यादिका श्रुतिः यं विनिद्रा जितश्वासाः संतुष्टा संयतेन्द्रियाः ज्योतिः पश्यन्ति युञ्जानास्तस्मै योगात्मने नमः इति स्मृतिः ताभ्याम् अवगम्यते इत्यर्थः श्रुतीज एंड स्मृतीज आर कोटेड वेयर बाय आत्मा इज नोन इन समाधि एज वन सेल्फ समाधि विल नॉट कॉज एनी नॉलेज ऑफ वॉट ऑफ तत्वमसी महावाक्य नॉलेज दैट इट वोंट कॉज बट आत्मा इज प्रत्यक्ष प्रत्यक्ष इन द सेंस नॉट एज एन ऑब्जेक्ट विदाउट एनी एडिशनल उपाधीज which have become visheshanas in sushupti avastha one is free from both but avidya veiling is there in samadhi avidya veil also goes away thereby one knows oneself as oneself as taught by the shruti in swarupa however aikya cannot be known aikya can be known only with mahavakya so mahavakya jnana cannot take place there anubhava बट वॉट इज दैट आत्मा अनुभव जीवात्मा शुद्ध आत्मा अनुभव विदाउट दी शरीरत्रय इज देर इन समाधि अवस्था नाउ श्रुति टीचेस दैट दिस इज सेम एज ब्रह्म चैतन्य परमात्म चैतन्य इट इज सेम सच्चिदानंद तत्व देर बाय द सच्चिदानंद स्वरूप नोन महावाक्य कैन बी अंडरस्टूड आफ्टर समाधि एज दिस इज माई स्वरूप ईश्वर स्वरूप एंड माय स्वरूप इज नॉट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम ईच अदर इट इज वन एंड द सेम देर इज नो सेकेंड दिस कैन बी नोन ओनली थ्रू श्रवण महावाक्य उपदेश बट जीव स्वरूप बीइंग सेपरेट फ्रॉम शरीरत्रय कैन बी नोन इन समाधि सो इट इज नॉट दैट वन कैन नॉट नो व्हेन द इंद्रियाज आर रिजॉल्व्ड Indriyas anyway cannot cognize and objectify Brahma. So when Indriyas are resolved and Antakkarana cannot objectify Brahma, so when the Antakkarana is also resolved, that time Atma stands in its own glory without any noise or without any mix-up, Mishrana. So So this is the Shuddha Atma which is known, and then one cannot object to Mahavakya Upadesha. There is nothing to object because one knows oneself as Shuddha Atma. Having come out of Samadhi, if Mahavakya was known, heard earlier and understood, Manana Siddha, then Samadhi works as Nididhyasana. As to, it takes away every objection to one not being Paramatma. Because anything that was an objection, contributing to the objection that I cannot be Paramatma, leading to viparita bhavana, opposite bhavana, opposite feeling, limited feeling, as opposed to limitless feeling. That goes away because all that was contributing to such an objection was what was created by the shariras. That I am a man, a woman, or a limited individual in a particular varnashrama, because the sharira has a varnashrama, has a particular age, with the buddhi being sharp or dull, with the mind causing emotions or very dry feeling even in emotional states. So some don't feel the emotion, where others are feeling emotion. There also, if I feel that I am lacking in emotion, then I am socially shunned. So that will also make me inquire, you know, why don't I have such feelings? Why don't I feel, whatever it is, why don't I feel this? I would like to feel, but I don't feel such an emotion towards, socially people say that, why don't you feel towards others? Why don't you visit people? Why don't you socialize more? I don't feel like socializing. Why not? That emotion is lacking perhaps. Becoming an introvert. Then all that is created by the mind. In Samadhi, all these are not there. These are the ones which are causing limitations. These are the ones which are separating me from Paramatma, making me limited. Those kind of objections are no longer possible if one has Samadhi Anubhava and understands the Mahavakya. Of course, Samadhi is not necessary because one understands in Sushupti, I am Sachidananda Swarupa, and in Swapna and Jagratavastha, all these limitations come by. If one understands that, then Samadhi Anubhava is not necessary for Mahavakya to work. But for Viparita Bhavana to go away, for Prarabdha Krita Dukkha to go away, one can counter by Samadhi even after Nididhyasana. Anyway, that is the Sampradaya. Here, back to the Sutra, Samadhi Avasthayam Krutartaha Pashyanti. Kim Pashyanti? Paramatmanam Pashyanti. Pashyanti meaning not objectify, but Atmatvena Pashyanti. They know, they have Anubhava, Anubhuti, Sakshatkara of that Atma which is free from the Shariratraya. Iti pratyaksha anumana abhyam, it is known through pratyaksha, shruti and smriti. These are the pramanas. Both shruti and smriti talk about the samadhi avastha. Kaschid dhiraha pratyakatmana maishyata, that is the katha upanishad, katha mantra says kaschid dhira, some rare person. Before this, the mantra which has gone by is Bhagavan himself has as though trapped the person, because from janma itself, naisargika, the indriyas are going outwards. Paranchi khani vetranat swayambhu. So one who is focused within instead of indriyas being let out to run haywire, kaschid dhiraha. So avrutta chakshuhu, kaschid dhiraha is avrutta chakshuhu, chakshu is upalakshana de, chakshur indriya. One who has brought his sense organs under his control and reversed them from going outside, he has reversed them into inquiry of Atma, Manana, and leading to Dhyana, one type of Samadhi, or Chintana, another type of Nididhyasana. One type of Samadhi being one type of Nididhyasana, and inquiry leading to contemplation which is meditative in ऐक्य ब्रह्माकार वृत्ति दैट इज समाधि विद दी वृत्ति बीइंग देयर ब्रह्माकार वृत्ति और विदाउट दी वृत्ति ऑल्सो वृत्ति शून्य निध्यासन बोथ आर पॉसिबल वन इज दी फॉर्मर विथ वृत्ति इज सविकल्पक समाधि एंड विदाउट वृत्ति इज निर्विकल्पक समाधि सो कश्चिद्धीर प्रत्यगात्मानम ऐक्षत वन सीज दिस ऐक्षत सॉ दिस मीनिंग इट इज इन श्रुति एवरी लकार इज लेट लकार इट इज अ विधि वन वुड सी इक्वल टू विधिलिंग वन वुड सी एनी वन कश्चिद्धीर एनी धीर हू हैज धैर्य टू गिव अप ऑल दी natural instincts and behavior of the indriyas, one controls them and brings in one's own vasha. The antakkaran also works under my say, then what will happen? Buddhi will be available when I want it to be available. The antakkarana will function as a mana when I want it to function as a mana. Indriyas will deal with only those vishayas where I have a say. They'll not drag me, I'll be their master. They'll not be the Swami, I'll be the Swami. And then, what will happen? Avrutta chakshu amrutattvam icchan pratyagatmanam aikshata. Desiring immortality. Amrutattvam icchan. Desiring immortality, what is the swarup of moksha? Indriyas going out will not let my avidya go away. This avidya will cause kama, further karma will cause vasanas and samskaras which will further keep on making avidya dhrida. Kama and karma will continue across janmas the way it has been going on since anadi kala. Then what will happen is that I won't be free. I'll be a mortal. I'll keep on getting janma after janma, mrityu after mrityu. But amrutattvam icchan, desiring amrutattva, कश्चिद्धीर आवृत्त चक्षु प्रत्यगात्मानम ऐक्षत सीज दिस स्वरूप ऑफ वनसेल्फ हैज साक्ष आत्म साक्षात्कार इत्यादि का श्रुति देर आर मेनी सच श्रुतीज एज प्रमाण फॉर समाधि देन यम विनिद्रा विनिद्राह जितश्वासाह संतुष्टाह संयतेन्द्रिया संयतेन्द्रिया जितश्वास दीज आर बहुरीज विनिद्रा ऑल्सो संतुष्टा दोज आर कंटेंट सम्यक तुष्टा दोज आर सम्यक तुष्टा हू आर कंटेंटेड विथ वॉट दे हैव दे डोंट इंद्रियाज टू ब्रिंग हैप्पीनेस संतोष इज देर जितश्वास दे हैव कंट्रोल ओवर देर प्राणाज मीनिंग द कर्मेन्द्रियाज विल ऑल्सो वर्क अंडर देर ओन से because prana will lead to indriyas functioning karmendriya and jnanendriya also without prana nothing will work we have seen this earlier so jita swasaha jita pranaha jitaha swasaha pranaha indriyani yaihi they are what by whom the indriyas pranas are won over they are called as jita swasa sanyatendriya jnanendriya as we can take sanyatendriya sanyataha संहितानि इंद्रियाणि यही बाय हूम दी इंद्रियाज हैव बीन कंट्रोल्ड एंड विनिद्रा मीन्स व्हाट व्हेन दीज इंद्रियाज आर कंट्रोल्ड व्हाट हैपेंस भगवान कारिकाकार सेज इन मांडुक्य व्हेन वन विड्रॉज दी इंद्रियाज एंड अंतकरण ऑल्सो व्हाट विल हैपन वन विल गो टू सुषुप्ति बिकॉज दिस इज दी जनरली एक्सपीरियंस्ड अवस्था As soon as the mind becomes dull, indriyas are not going outwards, then eyes will start closing. Even if the eyes are closed, the chakshurindriya which cannot force itself outside will start relaxing. Pranas are relaxed, breathing is shallow. Then what happens? There is very good reason for the buddhi also to switch off and go to sleep. Sleep mode. If that happens, then what have we gained? Nothing much. It is just that we have not done anything. It is like sleeping for more hours. So therefore, Karikakara says, be alert there. not so alert as to wake yourself up, but alert enough to not let yourself sleep. So that avastha where you are neither asleep nor the buddhi is so active that you are thinking something, indriyas are anyway controlled, they are shut off, then what happens? Nidra is not there. Vinidra, vigata nidra, yebhyah, te vinidraha, those who are without sleep state but whose indriyas are controlled, meaning they are in samadhi avastha. Then what do they jyoti pashyanti? They see this atma swarupa, prakashatma, prakasha swarupa atma, atmanam jyotihi pashyanti yunjanah tasmai, those who have controlled everything, who are in this yunjana, is in yoga avastha, yoga samadhu, samadhi artha, because yoga yunjana yujidhatu, this yujir yoge and then yuj samadhi also meaning is a samadhu. So samadhi meaning you have to take, because yoga with what? There is no joining with anything. You are already that swarupa where you are intending to join. There is no joining. Yoga, they say, you know, many of these granthas translate yoga as union. Union with what? It expects a karma. But samadhi meaning when you take, then it is withdrawn. Atma which is withdrawn in samadhi avastha, yoga, tasmai yogatmani namaha. To that yoga rupa atma itself namaha. Iti smriti hi tabhyam avagamyate cheto. Samadhi is the clincher for one who does not understand one's ananda swarupa in sushupti avastha. Incidentally, this came up in the vichara sagara also in Hindi in the last quarter yesterday. Nanu jiva brahmanoho dhyatrudhyeya bhavangikare bhedasyadityashankya aha. Now, so far Purvapakshi says you are saying that atma cannot be objectified and atma cannot be known so as an object, cannot be pratyaksha in that manner, but sakshatkara is called as atma pratyaksha. Then you said that atma can be known in samadhi by anubhuti, one's own swarupa can be known without any external sambandha with the vishaya or with the sharira itself, indriyas or pranas or antakkarana. Now this dhyana samadhi avastha through which you know yourself, then what has happened? This samadhi where pratyagatmanam aikshat you have said, so iksh dhatu is there, atma has become karma of that dhatu. This is what the people object to. Even in Siddhanta, people object to yoga for what reason? They say in samadhi, atma, anubhava they talk about. It is misunderstood. Atma, anubhava, people are rejecting. Even in Siddhantis, even in Advaita Siddhanta, there are many who reject yoga wholesale. What do they say? Atma, anubhava. Anubhava, anubhava, they talk about anubhava. Samadhi, anubhava. Anubhava unfortunately is translated as what? It is translated as experience in English, and this is the problem. When you say experience, then what happens? Experience of what? There is a karma expected, an object expected, experience of some object. But in samadhi there is no such object really. There can be, of course, in yoga samadhi there can be object where you do dhyana on an object, on nishta devata, on guru, on prana, on omkara, on some guna that I want, dhana, whatever it is. So there can be dharana dhyana samadhi on any mantra, any object, any sound, any vision, any rupa, any dharma. All these are possibilities. But samadhi which is attained by dhyana on the mahavakya will lead to aikya only, because there is nothing else. Dhyana vastu is oneself. So dhyana vastu is oneself in the sense what? Not as an object. Mahavakya vichara, collapses into a single. There are no two things. When the equation is solved, there are no two things. It is only a single entity. That is me in Swarupa. This is what the Mahavakya is teaching. When the Mahavakya says, Aham Brahmasmi, Aham I know, as something, Brahma is taught by Shruti as something. When I do Bhagatyaga Lakshana and then Satchidananda Swarupa on left side and right side, that is also Satchidananda Swarupa, Atom is also Satchidananda Swarupa. So Brahma is also Satchidananda Swarupa, Aham is also Satchidananda Swarupa. Then where are two? There are no two entities there. There is only single entity when the formula is resolved. Just like in mass, LHS equal to RHS. When LHS is solved, RHS is solved, both equations being solved, the equal to sign does not make any equation anymore. It is not a formula. Equal to sign is a statement of fact. Similarly, now when Aham Brahmasmi Mahavakya is understood, Manana is being done on that, and then Brahmakara Vritti is found in which Samadhi takes place, then it is a Samadhi where everything else is resolved and it is just my Swarupa which is shining forth. That is Samadhi there, where there is no objectification. So people who object to Anubhava because experience is a translation and they expect something, or Bhudhatu which is Anupurvaka, Anu plus Bhudhatu and Achpratya or something will give you Anubhava. Ghai or Ach, Ghai family Achpratya will give you Anubhava, Pullinga Shabda. So Anubhava, their Anupaschat, following something, that following something need not be a karma. This is misconstrued by the so-called sampradayas which have gone against the orthodoxy. These traditions have gone against the orthodoxy for whatever purpose. I am not questioning their purpose. I am saying that it's a misconstruction, it's a misconstruct. In their mind there is a misconstruct as to jnana is to be followed, not anubhava. There is no tarka basis for this. They lack tarka study. They throw away tarka also wholesale, yoga also wholesale. What happens then? When they throw away that part of tarka and sankhya and yoga, specifically yoga and tarka, where manana which is tarkatmaka, that manana also will be thrown. And when they throw away the yoga shastra also completely, then this Shamadamadi will also not be held well, because Shamadamadi are only Upalakshana for others. Bhagavan Gita Acharya counts 20 such gunas. So such 20 gunas are counted, and there are other places also more are counted. So all those have to be read together. We will see in the third pada of this as to how Upasana also works. How all the Upasanas mentioned in different shakas should be brought together and considered as a single Upasana. Similarly here all these Shama Dama are indicators of all the good values. All these sadhu dharma should be accumulated by the sadhaka. So when we are setting aside yoga shastra which talks about the sadhu dharmas, or it talks about the shruti, it parrots the shruti, we'll have thrown away such shruti also. This should be understood well as to the Ashtanga Yoga is a Shruti really. The Yoga has Sankhya part which we have seen. Sankhya has been refuted, Yoga has not been refuted. Yoga completely has not been refuted. We have seen under one Sutra earlier. Itine Yoga Prati Yukta also. Yogam Prati Yukta. Yoga also has been covered as refuted, but there is no refutation proper of Yoga. Meaning the Ashtanga Yoga. We have seen in the Vritti that Ashtanga Yoga is accepted in the Advaita tradition also. Now what happens is that when a person is saying Anubhava is unacceptable because Anubhava, every Anubhava is Atma Anubhava. This is what the claim is made. But then they say Jnana should be there. Unfortunately Jnana is Sakarmaka. Jnadhatu is Sakarmaka. It remains Sakarmaka. No matter what you do, Jnana will always expect something. If I say I have Jnana, what Jnana do you have? Alas, you'll have to say what Jnana. Jnana regarding which? So Jnana is Savishayaka. There is some Vishaya of the Jnana. I know दिस आई नो दैट, सो दिस और दैट इज एन ऑब्जेक्ट टू दैट न्या धातु. देयर फॉर भगवान भाष्यकार आई मेंशन दिस अर्लियर अंडर तैत्रीय उपनिषद सत्यम ज्ञानम अनंतम ब्रह्म दैट ज्ञान शब्द इज रिविजिटेड द सेकेंड टाइम. ही टेक्स अ पूर्व पक्ष एज टू ज्ञान इवन इफ इट इज भावे व्युत्पत्ति एंड मीन्स ओनली नॉलेज डज नॉट मीन एनी अदर कारकार्थ एनी कारकार्थ इवन देन दैट ल्युट इन नॉन कारका भावे व्युत्पत्ति ऑल्सो शुद्ध धात्वर्थ विल एक्सपेक्ट सम ऑब्जेक्ट बिकॉज ऑफ बीइंग सकर्मक धातु. कस्य ज्ञानम दैट कस्य इज कर्मणि षष्टि कस्य ज्ञानम कस्य ज्ञानम अस्ति भवतः कस्य ज्ञानम अस्ति किम जानाति भवान सो दैट जानाति ज्ञा धातु एक्सपेक्ट दैट किम इज अ विषय देर इट्स अ कर्म इट्स एन ऑब्जेक्ट. सो दोज हु से दैट अनुभव means experience which expects an object and one is trying to objectify atma, similarly trying to know jnana you are trying to objectify atma. Therefore bhagwan bhashyakara says jnana dhatu, although he has said earlier that it means nyaptihi meaning bhave yutpatti, still it will end up meaning only chaitanya. He says that even that is not the exact meaning, finally it is all neti neti prakriya. Similarly in samadhi it is a neti neti prakriya, I am not this, I am not that, and finally you land on the shuddha swarupa. Of course that cannot give you mahavakya jnana, that should be the counter and not that samadhi is all futile, because there is no tarka basis to this, as to there is no inquiry proper as to why anubhava is rejected and why jnana is not rejected. Jnana cannot be rejected because that is the sadhana for mukti as ordained by the Shruti. And the same Shruti talks about anubhava, anubhuti, it talks about sakshatkara, all these cannot be thrown. You cannot have ardhajarati and nyaya. Samadhi itself is a word in the Bhashya also and it is there in the Shruti also. Ashtanga yoga is a complete Shruti. There are yoga Upanishads proper. Upanishads cannot be set aside just because I have a methodology or we favor a particular thing. So it is better to say that, you know, it is not necessary is all right, but to say that all that samadhi is nonsense, it is not acceptable, because Bhagwan Bhashyakara is considered as the author of a vivarana on Vyasa Bhashya, which is on Yoga Sutras, and that vivarana defines samadhi as Atma Swarupa itself. So samadhi is actually resolution of everything which is Atma Swarupa. Nonetheless, this is a background to saying that tarka which defines स्मृति भिन्नम ज्ञानम अनुभव दैट अनुभव दैट ज्ञान विच इज ज्ञान इन स्मृति ऑल्सो देर इज ज्ञान मेमरी इज ऑल्सो ज्ञान बट स्मृति भिन्नम ज्ञान एवरी ज्ञान विच इज सेपरेट फ्रॉम मेमरी दैट ज्ञान इज अनुभव सो दी वर्ड्स आर इंटरचेंजेबल एक्सेप्ट फॉर दी मेमरी मेमरी इज नॉट अनुभव आई कैनॉट से दैट आई रिकॉल समथिंग and that recollection is my anubhava. It was anubhava back then. When I recall, that time it is not anubhava. This now I am recalling, that time it is not anubhava, but it is jnana. So this jnana of recollection is not anubhava. But recollection of whichever jnana it took place 5 years back, that time it was anubhava. Now it is not anubhava. But that time also it was jnana, now also it is jnana. This is the only difference between jnana and anubhava. As to smriti bhinnam jnanam anubhava, so every jnana is not anubhava, but every anubhava is jnana. These are interchange. This is tarka and siddhanti does not object to it. Siddhanti has not given a definition. I have inquired around, I have looked around. There is no definition for anubhava which is different given by the siddhanti. Whenever the siddhanti disagrees in any of the granthas, if there is a disagreement with the Tarkika, Tarkika is a Mukhya Purvapaksha, or his methodology is a Mukhya Purvapaksha rather. Their Darshana is also Purvapaksha, and Sankhyas or even Dvaitins today or Vishishta Dvaitins, they all end up using Tarka to argue. Therefore, Tarka can be considered as a, their Darshana or others' Darshana using Tarka is a Mukhya Purvapaksha. Siddhanti also uses the Tarka methodology to refute. So Lakshana has to be given. When we disagree with the Tarkika's Lakshana, then we give something. In, for example, in Vedanta Paribhasha, वेन दि सिद्धांति डिसएग्रीज विद दि प्रत्यक्षत्वम किम नाम प्रत्यक्षत्वम सो तार्किक हैज समथिंग इन हिज माइंड एंड ही विल कंसीडर ऑल दैट ही हैज एस्टैब्लिश्ड एज प्रमाण एंड कम टू द डिस्कशन टेबल और द डिबेट टेबल दैट टाइम वेन सिद्धांति इज सेइंग दिस इज नॉट प्रत्यक्ष देन ही विल से हाउ इज इट नॉट प्रत्यक्ष और हाउ इज इट प्रत्यक्ष ही मे आस्क हाउ इज इट प्रत्यक्ष देर इज नो इंद्रिया यू बींग यूज हियर सो फॉर दि तार्किका प्रत्यक्ष हैज इंद्रिया इन्वॉल्व इन सिद्धांत इंद्रिया इज नॉट नेसेसरली इन्वॉल्व इन प्रत्यक्षत्व सो सिद्धांति सेज दैट दैट इज युअर डेफिनेशन वाई डू यू टेक युअर डेफिनेशन टू माई टेबल वाई डू यू ब्रिंग इट टू माई टेबल वी डोंट एग्री विद दैट पार्ट सो वी विल गिव अवर ओन डेफिनेशन ऑफ प्रत्यक्ष वेर इंद्रिया इज नॉट इन्वॉल्व इन द लक्षण इंद्रिया इज नॉट इन्वॉल्व एट ऑल अदरवाइज Siddhanti makes another aksepa on the Purvapakshi. He says, you the Tarkika who considers Indriya as a contributor to Pratyaksha, without which Pratyaksha is not possible, for Brahma everything is Pratyaksha. And who is? Without Indriya. Achakshuhu. These are all Lakshanas of Ishwara. Ishwara is not without any Indriyas. He is not with any Indriyas. He is without Indriyas. Without Indriyas, Ishwara knows everything. Parabrahma knows everything. Without the Indriyas, goes everywhere, is available everywhere. Without Karmendriyas, also available everywhere. Without Prana, Pranaha, all these are mentions of Shruti, Shabdas of Shruti to talk about Parabrahma. So, Ishwara knows everything. For Ishwara, everything is Pratyaksha. Simultaneously, everything simultaneously, everywhere is Pratyaksha to Ishwara. Which Ishwara? That Ishwara who does not have any Indriyas. देन हाउ युअर प्रत्यक्ष लक्षण वर्क इन ईश्वर प्रत्यक्षत्वम ईश्वर प्रत्यक्षत्वम विल हैव अव्याप्ति ऑफ दिस प्रत्यक्ष लक्षण ऑफ तार्किक वी डोंट हैव सच इंद्रिया इन लक्षण ऑफ प्रत्यक्ष सिमिलरली इफ वी डिफर्ड फ्रॉम दि पूर्वपक्षी तार्किक इन दि अनुभव लक्षण श्रुति भिन्नम ज्ञानम अनुभव देन वी वुड हैव गिवन समथिंग वी वुड हैव गिवन सम अदर डेफिनेशन वी डू नॉट डिसएग्री Therefore, Anubhava and Jnana are interchangeable except for the Smriti. Whatever objection anyone is making to Anubhava will apply to Jnana equally. More so, in fact. Because Smriti is also Jnana. Anyway, this is the basis for my saying that Anubhava and Jnana should not be treated differently. One should not object to the words such as Atma Anubhava. There should be no allergy to it. Similarly, one should not have allergy to samadhi because there is anubhava talked of atma there. Here itself you see aikshat. Aikshat is jnana. When you say that aikshat means he saw. Pramana is chakshurindriya or samindriya whereby some vision is there, darshana. If you don't say it is literal, then what will you say? Like darshana in the atma vare drashtavya, darshana is not literal there. Because drishidhatu is sakarmaka. Drishdhatu is sakarmaka, you cannot have karma, atma cannot be karma there, but it has been used, atma vare drashtavya, atma should be seen. So there, seen means jnana, jnana there, for jnana also you will have to have an object there. If we do not take the literal meaning, we say it is jnana arthaka drashtavya is in the sense of jnana, jnatavya ityartha, then jnatavya means what, kim jnatavyam, atmanam jnatavyam. आत्मा ज्ञातव्यः नॉट आत्मानं ज्ञातो आत्मा ज्ञातव्यः सो आत्मा शुड बी नो इट विल बिकम एन ऑब्जेक्ट वी डोंट ऑब्जेक्ट देयर व्हाई बिकॉज आत्मा शुड नॉट बी ऑब्जेक्टिफाइड केन उपनिषद क्लियरली सेज दैट आत्मविज्ञान दैट इज टॉकिंग अबाउट ही सेज आई नो आत्मा वन हू क्लेम्स दैट ही हैज ऑब्जेक्टिफाइड वन हू नोज कैनॉट मेक अ स्टेटमेंट दैट आई हैव आई नो आत्मा He says, I am Atma. I am Atma is the Anubhava in Samadhi. It is not I know Atma. So it is very similar. So this should be understood. Only thing that we object is that it will not give any rise to knowledge of Aikya because Aikya Jnana will take place only in Shruti. By Samadhi, one will not get Aikya Jnana. One who has Aikya Jnana, Samadhi will give Dhridata and it will take away. विपरीत भावना इट विल टेक अवे संस्कार वासना क्षय विल बी द रिजल्टेंट मनोनाशा इज रिजल्टेंट. वन हु डज नॉट नो महावाक्य, फॉर हिम ओनली आत्मा इज नोन. देन महावाक्य वेन इट इज हर्ड, देन इट इज वेरी इजी टू नो, बिकॉज त्वम पदार्थ इज क्लियरली नोन, अनुभव सिद्ध एज वॉट एज आई एम आत्मा. त्वम पद डज नॉट मीन शरीर. देन वेन समबडी सेज तत्वमसि, दैट वाक्य विल कॉज ज्ञानोत्पत्ति कंप्लीट. सो इति स्मृताभ्याम अवगम्यते. सो स्मृति एंड श्रुति हैव बीन कोटेड. ननु जीव ब्रह्मणो ध्यातृदेह भावांगीकारे भेदस्याचाशंक्य. नाउ द ऑब्जेक्शन इज सिमिलर टू व्हाट बैकग्राउंड आई ब्रॉट इन. इट इज नॉट अ कंप्लीट असाइड बिकॉज दिस इज द ऑब्जेक्शन. वंस यू से समाधि, समाधि इज धारणा ध्यान समाधि. दी ध्याता इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम दी ध्येय, ध्येय वस्तु. आत्मा इज ध्येय यू आर सेइंग एंड ध्याता इज जीव. सो जीव एंड ब्रह्मात्मा विच इज ध्येय, बिटवीन देम देर इज अ डिफरेंस. आई कैन डू ध्यान ऑन समथिंग अदर देन मी, नॉट ऑन माई सेल्फ. सो ननु जीव ब्रह्मणो ध्यातृध्येय भाव अंगीकार. वेन यू एक्सेप्टेड दैट इन समाधि आत्मा इज नोन, देन दिस ब्रह्मात्मा इज सेपरेट फ्रॉम जीवात्मा. जीव एंड ब्रह्म हैव ध्यातृ एंड ध्येय भाव. जीव इज ध्याता मेडिटेटर एंड ब्रह्म इज ध्येय मेडिटेटेड ऑब्जेक्ट. देन वॉट भेद स्यात्, बिटवीन देम देर इज भेद. सो द्वैत, दिस इज वॉट दी अनफॉर्चुनेट कंक्लूजन इज देर इन योगशास्त्र फॉर दी सिद्धांतीज. सम सिद्धांतीज हु क्लेम देमसेल्फ टू बी शुद्ध वेदांतीज विल नॉट गो आउटसाइड शंकर भाष्य, विल नॉट कंसिडर एनी वन एल्स टॉकिंग अबाउट एनीथिंग ऑफ योगशास्त्र. साक्षात मधुरसुन सरस्वती आचार्य हैज टॉक्ड अबाउट टू टाइप्स ऑफ निधिध्यासना अंडर सिक्स चैप्टर ऑफ गीता. बट ऑल दिस इज नॉट प्रमाण फॉर देम. वाई? वी डोंट नीड ऑल दैट स्टडी. नॉनदलेस आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू शो दैट पॉइंट फिंगर्स टू एनी पर्टिक्युलर संप्रदायज, न्यूली क्रिएटेड संप्रदायज. बट आई वॉन्ट टू से हाउ दी संप्रदाय ऑर्थोडॉक्सी कैनॉट बी रॉन्ग. यू कैनॉट हैव सो मेनी ईयर्स ऑफ अविच्छिन्न संप्रदाय विच इज रॉन्ग. सो पॉइंटिंग फिंगर्स विल पॉइंट टूवर्ड्स दीज वेरी न्यू एज संप्रदायज, बट इट विल नॉट टेक अवे एनीथिंग फ्रॉम शास्त्र भाष्य ऑल्सो एंड श्रुति ऑल्सो. ऑल दिस इज श्रुति सिद्ध. देर कैनॉट बी एनी ऑब्जेक्शन. वन कैन ओनली से दैट दे हैव नॉट अंडरस्टूड, or for whatever reasons they are making this claim to serve their audience. But it is not a fact. We will be denying ourselves something if we start taking those kind of, you know, teachings literally. I particularly have a strong opinion against it, and I have voiced it. I have voiced it to Swamiji's also, whoever I have discussed with. I have voiced this, even if their opinion is different. I said that I do not agree. Because I cannot give up the orthodox sampradaya because even my teacher says so. It should be logical, it should be in line with Shruti. And this should be a bhava of each and every student. Shraddha, let the Shraddha be there. But that Shraddha should not be blind in something which is going against the Shruti. Shruti is the parama, this thing, parama pramana in this case. सो जीव ब्रह्मणो ध्यातृदेह भावांगीकारे भेदस्याशंक्या. टू दैट भगवान सूत्रकार इज एंसरिंग. ही सेज प्रकाशादिवच्च अवैशेष्यम प्रकाशश्च कर्मण्यभ्यासात्. प्रकाशादिवच्चावैशेष्यम प्रकाशश्च कर्मण्यभ्यासात्. लॉन्ग एंड काइंड ऑफ अ कॉम्प्लेक्स कंस्ट्रक्ट ऑफ द सूत्र. प्रकाशादिवत् च अवैशेष्यम प्रकाशः च कर्मणि अभ्यासात. दीज आर दी पदाज इन दी सूत्र. वॉट इज द मीनिंग देर? प्रकाश आदिवत, प्रकाश आकाश, दीज ऑल एग्जाम्पल्स हैव ऑलरेडी बीन यूज. प्रकाश हैज बीन शोन एज बीइंग वन विदाउट अ सेकेंड, बट अपियर्स विदाउट एनी शेप एटसेट्रा, बट अपियर्स टू टेक शेप बेस्ड ऑन द रिफ्लेक्टिंग बॉडी. आकार ऑफ विच एवर ऑब्जेक्ट इज बींग लिट अप बेस्ड ऑन दैट प्रकाश ऑल्सो सीम्स टू हैव टेकन सम आकार. सिमिलरली आकाश ऑल्सो घटाकाश मटाकाश, दैट काइंड ऑफ अ सेपरेशन इज देर इन व्यवहार, बट रियली आकाश इज वन विदाउट अ सेकेंड. सो प्रकाश इज नॉट चेंजिंग इन नाम रूप, इज नॉट चेंजिंग only due to nama rupa there is an appearance, there is a brahma of change in prakasha. Similarly, akasha also appears to be small or large based on upadhi of the ghata and matha, but really there is no difference. There is only single akasha, there is only one prakasha. Similarly, prakashadivacha brahman api avaisheshyam. Avaisheshyam, there is no vishesha, there is no segmentation, there is no difference. Brahma is one and only one. Ekamevadvitiya brahma, that is atma. So there is no difference between jiva and brahma. Avaisheshyam. And prakasha, prakasha is brahma prakasha, atma prakashascha kim? Ekaha, it is one. Just like prakashadi, akasha, prakasha is one, appears to be having bheda, but there is abheda, there is one indivisible prakasha and akasha. Similarly, this prakasha is atma. Prakashascha ekaha, atma prakashascha eka, paramatma prakasha eka eva, swarupatvena ekaha eva. But karmani, dhyanadi karmani bhinne api ekaha. So what does it mean is that prakashascha karmani, which karmani? Dhyana, which is the introduction, shanka by the introductory to this sutra, the introduction said, raised a doubt. Purvapakshi said, dhyatru dhyaya bhava angikare. So dhyatru dhyaya bhava angikare is what? Dhyana karma, in dhyana karma. So dhyana, dhyanadi karmani, in dhyana and adi also you can take any karma. In any karma, such as dhyana is also karma, meditation is also karma. Manasika karma, but it is still a karma. So in that there is a dhyatru and dhyaya bheda, which seems to be there. So bhinnyapi dhyanadi karmane bhinnyapi paramatmanastu ekah, paramatma tu ekah eva. Jiva brahmano ho, jiva paramatmano ho, bheda nasti ityartha. Ekah eva abheda vartate karmani. Why? Abhyasat. Hetu is abhyasat. Abhyasat means this abheda tattvamasi ityado abheda abhyasat. Abheda abhyasat. Eka abhyasat. This one thing being same as jiva also and as paramatma also has been mentioned with tattvamasya ityadi vakyas multiple times in the shruti. Abhyasa is multiple times. Abhyasat. Because of abheda being many times and abhyasa is a linga for tatpariya vishaya of the shruti. Out of the six lingas, abhyasa is one linga, shadvida linga, tatpariya linga, upakrama upasamhara ityadi. So abhyasa, apurvata, phalam, all these are lingas. Arthavada upapatti cha tatpariyam, these are the six. Tatpariya nischaye is a linga. Lingam tatpariya nischaye. Yatha saurah prakashaha, the surya, saura is surya prakasha. Saurah prakashaha angulyadi upadav karmani bhinna iva pratibhati vasutastu ekarupaha. Ekarupa eva appears how segmented. Another example is taken. What example? When you bring about your fingers, there are gaps within the fingers. So prakasha will become segmented. Instead of one beam which is coming through the window, let's say you have put your hand against the beam of light, then the beam will split into four. If you put your, because there are four gaps between five fingers, or if you put four fingers, three gaps between the four fingers, and outside there will be two as well beams. So multiple beams, basically how many ever you see based on how the beam is formed, will appear segmented, but prakasha is one and the same. So ungalyadi upadho, whether you place a finger or you know multiple fingers or something, you know, you cut some shapes in piece of cardboard and place that, whatever it is, angulyadi upadho karmani bhinna iva pratibhati, appears in such kind of karma as segmented, but prakasha vastutaha ekarupa. Tadvat prakasha, which prakasha? Paramatma api. Prakasha in swarupa, chaitanya swarupa paramatma. Dhyanadi upadho karmani bhinna iva bhati, appears to be different in dhyana etc. this Paramatma. There is a shruti to that effect. Jhayati va, lelayati va, as though meditates, as though moves. Basically, Paramatma is not moving. Atma is not doing dhyana. Antakkarana is being focused towards one vastu. Antakkarana is having vrittis. Atma is not having vrittis. Atma is free from all that. And when all those vrittis go away through a particular mechanism, then Atma shines forth as Atma. If the vritti is nidra vritti and through that nidra vritti it resolves, then one will have attained nothing, nothing other than nidra, sushupti avastha. But if it goes through, vritti goes, dies off on its own through aikya mahavakya, then the resolution is in one's own swarupa, because that is what the subject matter was, not an object, subject matter was that. And what is that subject matter? It is relating to me finally, because I am predicated to be Brahma, which was not known to me earlier. Now this Atma being known, into which understanding of Brahma is also there, that kind of resolution of the mind, vritti of the mind has taken place. Therefore samadhi is in oneself, not in any vishaya. There is no objectification at all. Kutaha abhyasat. Vastutaha tu avaisheshyam in ekarupatvam atmana. Atma has only avaisheshya, there is no segmentation. Kutaha abhyasat. Why? Tattvamasi ityadi abheda shruti abhyasat ityartha. Due to abhyasa, repetition of the fact of Atma being one with Brahma, that Brahma you are. 9 times it has been repeated in Chandogya Upanishad. Kincha, further what? Ato anantena. Ato nantena tatha hilingam, ato nantena tatha hilingam. Unfortunately, this avagraha sometimes throws me off. There is no pause there, should not be. And this avagraha, many people teach us, there has to be a pause. There should be no pause, it is a sandhi. Avagraha is not an akshara at all really. It's not a Sanskrit akshara, it is a printer's, publisher's choice to put some symbol. Single or double avagrahas. Sandhi is what? It is a ekarupa sandhi. The single okara is the adesha there. Ato nantena tathahi lingam. Ataha. If you pause, then you have to break. Ataha anantena tathahi lingam. Tathahi lingam. So ataha. Ataha, because there is no vaisheshya, there is only ekata, but avaisheshya, appearance, bheda, appearance of bheda is upadhi krita, due to upadhi. Therefore, what ataha anantena paramatmana ekatam gachati. So, the Shruti says ekatam gachati, which will be mentioned. Tatahi lingam. So, there is linga is there. Tatahi lingam. There is Shruti which says so, and linga is another pramana which is a particular shabda which reveals something, that is linga. So yato yatahi ataha is there. Atha is tasmat karanat, asmat karana, due to this reason. So from the earlier sutra you can take the reasoning, yato hi upadhi krutaha bhedaha. This bheda, what was said, this abheda shruti abhyasa confirms abheda. So bheda is pratiti matra. If bheda is pratiti matra, it is upadikrita. So yatohi yataha hi, yatohi upadikrita bheda, bheda upadikrita ataha. Therefore what? Vidyaya anantyena saha abhedaha. Through vidya what do you get? You get abheda. Abheda paramatma and jiva has no difference. Abhedaha tathahi lingam. Anantena, anantena paramatmana saha jivasya abhedaha. Since bheda is upadikrita between jiva and brahma, therefore with brahma paramatma jiva has aikya. Ananta brahma, ananta paramatma, jiva has aikya. Who feels limited, feels antavan. I feel I am antavan, but anantena saha abhedaha. Tatahi lingam, linga will see in the vritti. Atascha, therefore, and therefore, भेदस्य औपाधिकत्वात् विद्यया भेदं विदूय जीवोनन्तेन परमात्मना एकतां गच्छति। एकतां जीवः एकतां गच्छति अटेन्स एकता विद परमात्मा। जीव अटेन्स एकता विद लिमिटलेस परमात्मा। हाउ? भेदस्य औपाधिकत्वात् विद्यया भेदं विदूय। विदूय हैविंग गिवन अप भेद, गिवन अप भेद थ्रू विद्या, थ्रू ज्ञान, थ्रू उपासना, थ्रू ज्ञान इत्यादि वन कैन गिव अप दिस भेद। अहंग्रह उपासना विल ऑल्सो कॉज भेद निवृत्ति। भेदस्य औपाधिकत्वात् बिकॉज भेद इज ओनली एन उपाधि, इट इज नॉट अ विशेषण। शरीर इज नॉट अ विशेषण। भेद ड्यू टू शरीर इज नॉट माय रियलिटी, इट इज एन उपाधिकृत भेद। सो हैविंग रिमूव्ड दैट विद यूजिंग विद्या, विच विद्या तत्वमसि इत्यादि महावाक्य, देर बाय वॉट गिविंग अप भेद, हैविंग गिवन अप भेद विदुय लेबंत जीव परमात्मना सह, विच परमात्मा अनंत, अनंतेन परमात्मना सह एकतां गच्छति, अटेन्स वननेस। दिस अटेनमेंट इज अटेनमेंट ऑफ द अटेन, ऑलरेडी अटेन, वॉज ऑलरेडी एक। भेद वॉज, segmentation was created due to upadhi, having given up the upadhi what happens, ekatam gachati meaning as though attains oneness was already one, the appearance was mithya, was brahma, when the brahma goes away then abheda shines forth, aikya shines forth on its own, ekatam gachati tathahi lingam, what is the linga, what indicates such kind of a thing, how did you conclude, so ask the purvapakshi to that, siddhanti says sayo havai तत्परम तत्परमं ब्रह्म वेद ब्रह्मैव भवति इत्यादि अपूर्वार्थ ज्ञापकम् इत्यर्थः। व्हाट इज नॉट नोन एल्सवेयर, अपूर्व अपूर्व अर्थ ज्ञापकम्, दैट विच रिवील्स, दैट विच इज अ रिवीलर, ज्ञापक, रिवीलर ऑफ व्हाट, ऑफ अर्थ विच इज अपूर्व, अर्थ विच इज prior unknown, which can never be known through any other means including samadhi, but only by mahavakya which can be known. It cannot be known through karmakanda, it cannot be known through meaning karmas, karma yoga, it cannot be known through bhakti, it cannot be known through anything else except for mahavakya. It cannot be known through avantara vakyas or upasanas, it can be known only through mahavakya. Therefore, apurva, apurva artha jnapakam, which is that ityadi, these kind of shrutis, such as what? Saha, saha yaha, ha, indeed that one who, vai, tat paramam brahma veda, one who knows that param brahma, which that Upanishad purusha, which is known only in Upanishad, only through Upanishad, that Upanishadam purusham, paramam brahma, which is paramatma, parabrahma, Veda, one who knows Brahma eva bhavati, he is Brahma. Bhavati can also be translated is, many people translate as becomes, so becomes Brahma. So becoming has some misconception, the word itself has a understanding just like experience. Experience is a word which is understood as having some object, experience of an object, just like ignorance. What is ignorance? Absence of something. Avidya or ajnana translated as ignorance, unfortunately due to lack of a better word in English, does injustice to it. Ignorance means absence of something. You don't need anything for that. It cannot cause anything. Ignorance cannot lead to anything. Absence cannot lead to any positive presence. So avidya or ajnana is virodharthe nan. We have seen many times as to it is opposed to vidya or jnana. Aikya jnana or aikya vidya is opposed by ajnana. It has some kind of a positive presence, mithya presence. Similarly here, if you say bhavati as becomes, English translation means that it is the expectation that because in English bhudhatu translation becomes, there also the sentence construct and the English grammar is such that the predication is considered as an object, unfortunately. It is not an object. So becomes, it is a statement of fact, he is Brahma. One who is, who knows Brahma, knows that he has always been Brahma. That is the real meaning there. So when you say becomes Brahma, it is not a predication, it is not an object. which the some status which is gained, but what was never lost was having a Brahma of something else. That something else goes away, and one who was Brahma plus something is now only Brahma. That is the meaning there. Brahma ityadi apurvartha jnapakam ityartha. So jnapakam, linga is jnapakam. This is the revealer of what? Ekatam gachati. One attains oneness as though. But oneness, you can say one attains oneness. Meaning what? One who was one all along thought himself to be the Sharira, etc., and changing with the Sharira. So he was with the Upadhi, he was having multiplicity, all that goes away. As though schizophrenic, you know, has one mood one time and has another mood. If you can segment a person, you know, it does not appear to the same person. One who is angry does not appear to the same person. You can say, how can it be? If you hear his voice also will be different. If you have not heard that person in high pitch or something, you'll say that. If you just hear a recording, you'll say, I don't know this person. Who is this? I don't know. So as though schizophrenic, there are multiple personalities there based on emotions. All that goes away. Anyway, all this is just to explain the ekata can be said to be prapta, but it was already one with Brahma. We'll see more in the next part. आम्नायांतिक संसिद्धम आदि मध्यांत वर्जितम आनंद घनम अपूर्णम आत्मज्योतिरुपासमहे नमस्ते धन्यवाद.